want to introduce you to piecewise functions. Now, a piecewise function is simply a function made up of pieces of other functions in a way that the domains don't overlap, which keeps it being a function. For example, the graph shown below is made from three different line segments. The first line segment is a decreasing line segment. It starts at negative infinity and goes through points -4, -1, and -2, -3. The second line segment is horizontal and it goes from -2, -3 over to 1, -3. And finally, the third line segment is increasing. It starts at 1, -3 and goes through a point at 2, 1. These three line segments make the graph of f of x, and you can see that the graph does pass a vertical line test, so it is a function. We're going to begin by evaluating several expressions written in function notation. Let's start with f of -5. We're looking for the output when we input -5. So when we input -5, the output that we get is actually on the x-axis. It's a value of 0. F of -4, we'll go over to the x value of -4. That's our input. Our output value is on the graph of f of x itself, and it's at -1. So our f of -4 equals -1. F of -2 takes us to the point where two of the line segments meet, which is at -2, -3. So the input is -2 and the output is -3. At this point, why don't you pause this video and take just a couple seconds to try the last three yourself. F of -1, f of 1, and f of 2. Alright, hopefully you've given that a try. Let's start with f of -1. At a value of x equals -1, the y value of the graph is -3. We're on that horizontal line segment. So f of -1 is -3. F of 1 tells us that 1 is our input, and so -3 is our output. That's the last point from left to right on that line segment that's horizontal. So f of 1 is also -3. Finally, f of 2 is an input of 2 and an output of 1. And so that puts us on the very steep increasing third line segment. Now, we can actually write an equation for each of these lines. For now, I'm just going to give you the three equations. The first line segment is the equation y equals -x - 5. The second line segment, the horizontal one, is the equation y equals -3. And the third line segment, that steep increasing line segment, is the equation y equals 4x - 7. Each line segment is used for a certain portion of the function f of x. In other words, we use each line segment for a specific domain. We use line 1 when x is less than -2. We use line 2, that horizontal one, between x is -2 and x is 1. We write that -2 is less than x is less than 1. And finally, we use the third line segment when x is greater than 1. Now, this leaves us with a question about what actually happens at x equals -2 and x equals 1. Which line are we actually on? Well, in this case, line segment 1 and line segment 2 meet at the x value of -2. So we want one of those two line segments to be equal to -2. It doesn't matter which one we choose. So let's just choose line 1 to be equal to -2 at that point, giving us the domain x is less than or equal to -2. We have the same issue at x equals 1. Both graphs of line 2 and line 3 are equal to the point 1, -3. We need for one of those line segments to actually have value. I'm just going to choose the second line segment to have value there. So I'll write the second line's domain as -2 is less than x is less than or equal to 1. Again, that's an arbitrary choice. You could have chosen the opposite sides to be equal. As long as one function is equal where the two meet, then we're good. Now, using this information, we can write what we call a piecewise function for the graph of f of x. We say f of x equals, and then we use a curly left brace, and it's going to have three parts held by that curly left brace. Now we'll put in the three different line segments and the domain that they're used in. The first line segment would be f of x equals -x - 5, and we use that if x is less than or equal to -2. The second line segment is always equal to negative 3. So we'll write negative 3, and we'll use that if negative 2 is less than x is less than or equal to 1. And the third line segment is given by 4x minus 7, and we'll use that if x is greater than 1. This gives us a formula for a function made up of three pieces, three line segments, each with its distinct formula and domain. Now, using this formula we've written, we can evaluate with function notation. So for example, if I want to evaluate f of negative 6, I need to look at the domain condition that lets me use negative 6, which is x is less than or equal to negative 2. In that case, I'm going to evaluate the function negative x minus 5. So I'm going to put in negative 6, the number I'm evaluating at, which gives me a positive 6 minus 5, or the value of 1. How about f of 0.1? Well, again, I'm going to figure out which of the three line segments I can evaluate with 0.1. 0.1 is between the x values of negative 2 and 1, so I want to use the second line segment. And in the second line segment, everything's always equal to negative 3. There's no x value to put in there. It's just negative 3. And finally, f of 4. Well, 4 is an x value greater than 1, so I can use the third line segment to evaluate that. 4 times parentheses, that's empty, minus 7. And I'm going to put the 4 in that parentheses. So now I have 4 times 4 minus 7, which is 16 minus 7, or 9. So I know that f of negative 6 equals 1, f of 0.1 equals negative 3, and f of 4 equals 9.